Today, we build a home for ants. Ants are really interesting animals and fun to watch. If you want to keep ants at home, they need a nest called a formicarium and an arena where you can feed them. In this video, I will build a modular system for my ants. The arena is a simple box that I built as a parametric model in FreeCAD. The model is nothing special, just four walls and a lid with some vent slots. I am cutting all the parts on the K40 laser cutter. While this was no problem for the walls, the acrylic lid started to warp during all the heat from the cutting and the thin areas. For the lid to lay flat on the arena, I applied a good amount of clamping pressure and annealed the acrylic at 80 degrees for 30 minutes in the oven. After taking the lid out of the clamps, it is perfectly flat and I can glue the handles in place. Aligning all the elements of the box is not easy. I'm cutting a few plywood templates to help with the alignment. With the templates and tape, gluing the arena together is relatively easy. While the glue of the arena is drying, we can take care of the formicarium. The formicarium is a simple box from black acrylic that has a transparent front to watch the ants in their nest. All the parts are cut on the K40 and then glued together with a simple jig to ensure a right angle. From small acrylic offcuts, I cut these nut anchors. These will be embedded in the concrete and act as an anchor for screws that will hold the transparent panel in place. The bolts are connected to the nuts and the nest is assembled. Before pouring the concrete, we have to install the connectors. These pieces are simple models with a threaded outside and a snap-on ring that holds them in place in the inside. Later in the video, I will take a look at the different options of modules that can be screwed on these connectors. On the laser, I have cut the negative form of the interior of the nest from XPS foam. The foam is glued with PVA to the protective cover of the acrylic so that it doesn't float on the concrete. The connectors are connected to the interior nest with some odd-shaped XPS pieces. Now we are ready to pour the concrete. After the concrete is cured, I remove all the XPS foam pieces piece by piece. I paint a layer of lime putty on the concrete to make the environment mold resistant, and the white background provides a nice contrast for the black ants. The ants I keep are from a tropical climate, so the nest and the arena have to be heated to around 26 to 28 degrees Celsius. I used this project as an excuse to finally learn how to design a PCB board. I have to say that it was quite simple and I was surprised that this circuit worked on the first try. Here you see me mounting a small display in a 3D printed box that will later show the temperature and the humidity in the nest and in the arena. The red LEDs indicate that the heating is switched on and the blue LED shows a low humidity. To get the temperature and the humidity, we have to install a sensor. This is where the connectors I mentioned earlier come in handy. These 3D printed caps have a recess that fits snug around a DHT22 sensor that measures temperature and humidity. The sensor is glued in place with a drop of epoxy. On the outside of the cap, I solder a GST connector and a pull-up resistor to the sensor. All of the electronic components are housed in a laser-cut MDF box. For the heating of the arena, I have to install a heating element. A piece of XPS foam is shaped so that the heating element from a car mirror sits flush with the surface. To hide the XPS foam, we glue a simple plywood cover together. After the glue dried, the plywood is sanded and stained. The connectors for the arena are put in place and secured with a snap-on ring. These connectors have already caps with a mesh for some additional airflow installed. After installing the other connectors, a 16mm transparent hose connects the arena with the nest. I later developed some more modules for the connectors. With this syringe, I inject water to increase the humidity in the nest. And if you want to decrease the humidity, you can put on these fan holders on top of a connector and increase the airflow. The work that you just saw actually happened 3 years ago. The ants moved in and they have been growing a lot. They have been growing so much that I had to build a new formicarium, which was really easy to connect to the existing arena thanks to the modular system. At the moment, the ants have moved out of the old nest and most of them are in the new one. Let me know in the comments what you think about the design and let me know in case you're interested in the 3D models. If there are enough people interested in the STL files, I will share them on my website.